Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and I would like to wish you all a very happy St. Patrick's Day. I spent the day, this is my day, I did 3 loads of laundry, I went to the grocery store, I cleaned the house, and that's about it. I didn't have any green beer, but I hope you guys did. Dave worked days today, and he's got clients tonight in his private practice. So poor Jimmy here is by himself. That's okay. So anyway, I'm here to talk about the question of the week. And I actually posed the question this week, and I'll read it to you. Here in the United States, there are certain organizations that have come about, some of them after the advent of the internet, such as the National Organization of Marriage, Focus on the Family, Exodus International, the American Family Association, and the list goes on, that make their money from donations from ordinary people and religious institutions. They all demonize gay people and gay relationships and gay families by distorting the truth and basically lying about us and preaching fear and homophobia to get people who are not educated to give them money. How, as an LGBTQ person, does that make you feel? Well, to me, it makes me mad. I really am so mad. These people are lower than low. They really are. They found out that if you make people fearful by telling lies about gay people, that they will send you money. And really, folks, it is all about this, isn't it? It's all about money. Send me money. Send me money. And, you know, it makes me sick because I work in a job, I work in a hospital, and all the money that I make, I know I've made it honestly. But these people are worse than the worst, especially with all the bullying and the kids killing themselves and committing suicide because of the lies that these people tell. It just makes my stomach churn. It really does. I made a list of some of the lies that they put out there. Well, the number one that's really close to my heart is they say that gay men are incapable of having a long-term monogamous relationship. Well, I don't know what to tell you about that. I mean, Dave and I have been together for 20 years. You know, That is such a lie. And I know other gay couples that have been together even longer than us. So that's lie number one. Here's lie number two. Most gay men are HIV positive. Well, no. We're not. I'm not HIV positive. And I'm not saying if you are HIV positive, then you're lucky that you live in a time where there is medication that can help you, but we're not. Here's lie number three. Gay people are commonly pedophiles. Now, that is absolutely, completely hurtful and ridiculous. I could never, ever touch a hair on a child's head. Children are not sexually attracted to me at all. My partner is, but he's big and hairy. Maybe. But, I mean, that is so ridiculous, so insane. And studies have proven that is just not true. What's the next one? People that embrace the homosexual lifestyle are more likely to become addicted to drugs and alcohol and have shortened lifespans. Again, like I told you, I didn't even have a green beer today. So, and I'm not into drugs. You know, to me, my body is my vehicle through this life, and I don't want to destroy it. So that's another big lie. Gay people like to recruit other people into their lifestyle. Please. I don't know about you, but like Lady Gaga says, I was born this way. There's no way you can make a straight person gay or and take them into your bosom and make them a gay person. That's so ridiculous. Another thing, the reason I said that, they always say it's always the homosexual lifestyle. Well, first of all, it's not a lifestyle. It's just who you are. It's like having red hair. It is. But they always say homo. They never say gay. They always say homosexual because that sounds kind of scary. And you have to remember too that sometimes the people that are the most vocally homophobic are actually closeted gay people. I mean, we've seen this over and over and over again with politicians and stuff. And you know, I really hope for them that they do come out of the closet. And the reason I think that they're doing this is because they're so miserable with themselves. The Catholic Church is to blame as well, and the Mormon Church. They gave millions and millions of dollars so far to defeat marriage initiatives in states like in Maine and California, and the Mormon Church is just as bad. These people, I really don't understand if the people that are heads of these churches, you would think that they would want to be open their umbrella and include more people into their church for money, but they don't. I can't even tell you how stupid that is, because I don't know about your family, but I was raised Catholic, and I don't go to church anymore, and none of my family does because of the stupid things that they're doing. Like, they really need to get it into the modern times. And my dad was an avid Catholic, and you know what, he threw money into the basket every single Sunday, and I wonder how he would feel now that if he knew that these people were spending money to not only pay off pedophile priests, but also to make sure that my partner and I cannot get married. I think he'd be really mad as well. The United States, I think, really is taking a back seat as far as civil rights. You know, there's been gay marriage in Europe for quite some time now, and Canada, and even Argentina. But here we sit, and it makes me sad as being an American, because at one time I think we were at the forefront of civil rights, and it's just not that way anymore. So I guess there's one more thing. That the National Organization of Marriage, do you honestly believe that they care anything about the sanctity of marriage between a man and a woman? Or do you believe that it's all, again, about this? It's all about this. They constantly are asking for donations, and it's to fill their bank accounts to pay these awful, crazy, wicked people lots of money. And Maggie Gallagher, who is the head of it, and by the way, her name isn't Gallagher. That was her maiden name. I wrote this down. Her maiden name is actually Srivastav or something like that. She goes by Gallagher because that is more appealing to the Irish Catholic people that have this to give to them and to put into their bank accounts. And I hope someday, I really do, that I will see the day when Maggie Gallagher is at the local McDonald's saying, "Would you like fries with that?" I really do. So I'm going to get off my soapbox, but I just wanted to talk to you about that. I hope you guys have a good weekend. We really don't have anything planned this weekend. I think we're just going to hang out here around the house. So anyway, thanks for listening, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.